With 3 decades of experience of printing and embroidery, Acorn Printing have a client base including many household names and have even supplied t-shirts for the President of the United States. As the official teamwear supplier for BOSRA, you can order from our current range at t-shirtuk.com. Good morning, iRacing fans. Welcome to the 2016 BOSRA MSA Skip Barber Championship Round 12 from Okayama International Circuit Full Course. We're reaching the closing stages of the event now, and 16 cars on the grid this week. It was Anton Ades who took pole once again, 8.145.512, almost 0.3 of a second quicker than Sir Brandon second. Tony Bird is in third ahead of Neil Bamber and Barry Bird in fifth. Al McCain sixth with Van Delden seventh and Simon Underhill in eighth. David Rowan qualified ninth ahead of Gawinicki and Daniel Honeysmith, with Simon Jackson for Bentley Boyd in 12th ahead of Chris Buttrell and Jan Elizabeth. The final two cars on the grid this week is Ian Thorne and Ryan Walker. Our onboard lap this week comes from Tony Bird, so let's jump on board with him now for a 1:45.904. If you're looking to upgrade your racing experience, then head over to Bowden Solutions. They offer the first and only bolt-on load cell brake mod for Thrustmaster pedals, and the TXG27 adapter allows you to use your Logitech pedals with the Thrustmaster wheel. See the link below for more information. Tony just starting his fastest lap of the session now. It was lap number 10 of the session, and straight away we're into the first corner. We've got 11 corners here at Okayama Full Course, and all our drivers are quite familiar with this course by now. We've visited here so many times throughout the past year and a half. Into corner number 2, this is Williams, and then we make our way down towards the Moss S and heading up towards Outward Curve, which is a 180 degree right hander, and then we move up onto the back straight. So through the Moss curves, nice and easy through here from Tony. Going in and hard on the brakes now as we go into Atwood Curve and keeping it tight in here. It is uphill and it does run out wide on the left hand side, so you can veer out there if needed. A great place to catch people in the slipstream here, especially in the skip barbers. Foot now hard to the floor, staying to the left hand side of the track. We're going to be looking out for the marker boards as we make our way up to turn number 5, which is the hairpin. After that we go into revolver. So there you can see the marker boards on the left hand side, on the brakes at the very last second. Keep it all the way hooked to the curb through here and keeping on the right hand side of the track. As we make our way now to revolver, which goes downhill a little bit, you can run wide here and through the short part of the circuit where it rejoins the track there. Many cars spin out here and into the wall, so we keep it nice and straight through there. Now making our way down towards Redmond and then up to Hobbs. This is a left right, so first we go through the left hand part of this, again keeping it out wide if we can. Great passing opportunities here as well if cars do veer out wide. Through there, we're making our way down to Mike Knight Corner and the entrance on the pit on the right hand side. So past the entrance of the pits now we come, once again over the rumble strips and let it out to the left hand side, try and get a good exit through here and onto the main straight, through last corner, turn number 11, and onto the pit straight itself. Tony going as fast as he can to try and catch Anton Ades and Sobran, but it wasn't to be, so settle in for third place this week. So now qualifying's out the way, let's head over to the race. The Synology DS216 Play is a 2-bay NAS featuring 4K video transcoding and powerful processing capabilities. Complement yours with Seagate NAS hard drives for the perfect high-capacity storage solution. See the video description for more details. Motorsport auctions are the global marketplace to buy and sell used racing rally cars, parts, transporters and associated equipment. With competitive pricing on all types of membership, list your items now at motorsportauctions.com. So there you have it with the race results then. This week it was Antonades who got the better of Sobrant and Bird, only 2 seconds covering the top three. Neil Bamber finished fourth ahead of Barry Bird and Simon Underhill, with Gwenicke in seventh ahead of Van Dalden in eighth. Then it's Bentley boys David Rowland in ninth ahead of Chris Buttrell and Simon Jackson, with Alan McCain and Jan Mullers the next. In Thorn, Ryan Walker and Daniel Honeysmith, well, they were quite far behind, with Daniel Honeysmith 20 laps down. Moving now to the driver's standing, Sobrant still leads by 30 points ahead of Antonades, with Bamber 69 points behind. Simon Jackson's in fourth ahead of Van Dalden and Gowenicke, with Simon Underhill moving up one, as does Barry Bird. Phil Gregory drops 2 places to ninth, 113 points behind. Tony Burt in 10th ahead of Ben Hackerson and Alan McCain. Chris Buttrell's 14th, David Waldock drops 2, with Darren Ford in 15th and Jan Mullersver in 16th. In the second half of the table, Matt Talaya stays 17th and David Rowan moves up 2 into 18th. Russell Barnes and Ian Robson drop down. Walker, Piercy, Green and Ian Thorne all stay where they are, as does Honey Smith and Martin Brandon. And further down, John Woolridge, 3 points for him in 32nd. In the team standings, it's getting closer. XL Designs lead by 19 points, with Bowden Solutions just 30 points behind now. Team Quad Worker down one into 4th, ahead of Bentley Boys Racing and Motorsport Auctions. Tech Speed Racing in 7th and Acorn Print in 8th. For round 13, we're off to Lamrock Park for the chicane course there, so don't forget to join us for that next week. And as usual, thank you ever so much for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.